defenseman for the Boston Bruins. Matt, congratulations on the new deal. What does it mean for you to stay and play for the team that you grew up rooting for the foreseeable future?
Yeah, it means everything. Obviously, the goal is to certainly stay in Boston as long as I can, and I'm extremely thankful to the Jacobs family and Don Sweeney for having that belief in me and wanting to extend me for four more years. So I'm just looking forward to take advantage of the opportunity.
Matt, you played on a really good team since you've come into Boston. A couple of those players are not back yet. Tor Krug gone for good. Char, we're not exactly sure. So it looks like your role with the new contract is going to grow. What are you doing to make sure you're ready and capable of stepping up to playing the same kind of quality, but maybe in a little tougher role?
Well, you know, obviously, first and foremost, want to make sure I'm coming into this year in best shape possible. It's always the goal in each offseason. And obviously, it's the teams are going to look a little different. So this year, I want to, you know, ask myself more from an offensive standpoint and add a little bit more of that into my game and be able to walk pucks on the blue line and get more pucks in the net so that we can play a little bit more with it in the offensive zone and grow my game that way.
Matt, Tory Krug's not there, but also a shorter stature kind of defenseman. Left shot guy, had great success in Boston. Big fan of yours. We saw him congratulate you on the new contract. Can you learn and have you learned anything from being around Tory Krug and the way he plays offensively that you can maybe try to bring into your game?
Yeah, I think, you know, Tory's always been an incredible friend to me and someone who has really shown me the ropes ever since I've been a part of the organization. And I'm forever grateful for him for not only being my friend, but also being a great mentor for me and showing me that, you know, doesn't matter how big you are or how smart you are, you can still play in this league. So I obviously, I get a good seat watching him the past couple of years run the power play and you know, really take over games offensively. So it's been fun to watch, and I've tried to pick up a few things along the way, and just seeing how much confidence he has in his game and seeing how that translates to, you know, success for the team. And I think I want to take a bit of a step in that direction and, you know, walk around with kind of more of that swagger.
In looking at the pairings on paper right now, it looks like you and Charlie McAvoy might be paired up on that top pair. Do you have any indication of where you might be slotted in on that back end? And if so, what is the chemistry like between you two guys? Because it goes back to your BU Terrier days.
Yeah, I haven't really figured that out. Obviously, you know, teams are still trying to figure out who's going to be there at the end of the day come training camp. And whatever role I have, I want to make sure that I'm prepared for that and ready to take on more minutes and more responsibility. I have had the opportunity, obviously, like you said, to play with Charlie now even before the Bruins. And I think everyone knows he's an unbelievable player. And it's awesome getting to share the ice with him. And I think that we see the ice pretty similarly, and we both want to jump up in the play. But I feel that we're both pretty defensively responsible at the same time. So if one guy's up, we make sure that one guy's back as well. And it's been great. It's been great seeing, you know, how he's developed over the last couple of years. Even though he's younger than me, I feel like he's really grown into more of a leadership role himself. And it's been fun to watch and fun to be a part of.
I don't know. If you get paired together, just remind him, he's still younger than you, right? You're the veteran around here. And you can take that role on. Now, listen, Matt, congratulations. Business part of the summer, done. Very nicely done. Four-year extension. Now it comes time for preparation, as you mentioned. How do you figure out how to prepare when there is an uncertain start date?
I think that I didn't want to take too much time off of training, first and foremost. I felt like we got quite some time off during quarantine and with the whole coronavirus out of the bubble. I've just been trying to get back into the gym and feeling really healthy and wanting to take advantage of that. Hopefully we'll get back on the ice soon. But, you know, I think about just wanting to get more mentally prepared, and whether that's, you know, maybe starting to watch video a little bit earlier than I would in a normal off season, and especially if that power play role, you know, is available and up for grabs. I want to make sure that when I get on the ice, I'm feeling prepared and seeing the ice and seeing where players will be available if that opportunity does open up. So I think that those are certainly things that I'm working on.
Matt, real quick follow-up. That's something that, you know, I certainly was not able to do, whether technology or coaching, you know, get into the video and kind of explore different parts of getting better beyond the gym or the ice. Do you have somebody or a team of people that kind of guide you, whether it's mental preparation, sports psychologists, whether it's video work coming out of the Bruins? Like, how do you tap into those different parts of trying to get better?
Yeah, we actually work with a team psychologist. We usually see about once or twice a month during the season, just checking in and making sure that we're in a solid place mentally. We're feeling prepared throughout the season. Also, Matty Myers, our video guy, does a good job of documenting our shifts right away. And if we want to, you know, watch each and every game, he'll break it down for us. Or the coaches are really good too themselves at breaking things down and making sure that if we have any sort of questions or areas that they want to focus on, they'll reach out to us and making sure that they're always available. So that's always you know, a huge advantage as a player, and you want to take full advantage of that.
All right, Johnny's got the hard-hitting questions. I'm going with off the grid on this one. And Nathan MacKinnon certainly made waves on social media the other day. Mm-hmm. Instagram story posting the gloves that he's maybe trying to break in right now. We might see a Nordique sweater this year. Rumors out there, some of the teams may be going retro. You grew up in Boston. Your thoughts on the Pooh Bear coming back for a couple of games for the Boston Bruins this year? Can you break any news for us?
I haven't heard anything, but I feel like with that one especially, it's people either love it or they hate it. I think it's pretty cool, to be honest. It's got that unique yellow look. I'm sure not everyone's a fan of it, but I certainly am, and I wonder if they could maybe put their own little spin on it, but I'll keep you guys posted if I hear anything.
Well said.
I
well
played against
said
that Pooh Bear. I didn't like it so much.
All right. Hey, like he said it. You either love it or you hate it. Matt, we love to see you on the ice. Congratulations on the new deal, and we look forward to seeing you and your Bees teammates on the ice, hopefully sometime in the near future.
Thank you, guys. Appreciate it.
All right.